game one. It's only a best of three, so game one, that lead is going to really matter.
Yeah, as you said, the first winner is of course going to have a huge advantage in their pockets. For Baby and Juan, both looking to secure that advantage. Of course, the pre-ban is always the first thing we got to get through, a very important part of the draft, as we see on Gilkey.
You have to be afraid of that monster at this point.
Absolutely.
I am not surprised that 4Baby just doesn't even want to have to deal with considering it as a post-ban. Just says, please get that out of this game. Ragdoll going to be the pre-ban against 4Baby as we see some quick first picks coming out from both players.
Right, so this is where we see some of the advantage come out of being a player that plays later on through the stages, because he has seen this on Gilkey shred through too many enemies, as he now, once he bans it, brings a different version.
Okay, the Kinky coming out for 4Baby, but Juan has a lot of Onimusha still available.
That's true. Wonder
if that's going to still be the answer.
Oh!
Okay, still new monsters that we haven't seen yet.
Ziana.
In the impact preliminaries, does it get all secured here for Juan?
Ziana Savannah, AoE for days is what Juan says. Paired up with the Nephthys, Jogun, they do have some synergy going right now. Juan is literally saying, AoE is my way. Also sticking true to the Ragdoll pre-ban, so it just really adds up. Juan, he knew what he was going to do. Of course, Leo is a bit of an eyesore, though.
Leo always going to be that go-to answer against these Beast Riders, topped off with Diana on the side of 4Baby.
There is Gemini for the first time here today, providing armor break, strip, speed leader. This guy has it all. It's a no-brainer ban on Leo here if you're Juan. But if you're 4Baby, there is just so many bans to consider. Do you want to get rid of the attack buff? Do you want to get rid of some of the damage? You know, either Savannah or Ziana. There's 9 seconds left ticking.
So lots of considerations for 4Baby. What's it going to be? Juan, we seem to have a good grasp. Of course, it is going to be that Leo. The Joe Gun going to be banned out for 4Baby.
So the attack buff has been taken out. Now, Juan, you've been given your combo. You need to show us how it is executed. We are loading up the game for you guys, ladies and gentlemen. The first round between Juan and 4Baby. Fly Fly comes out, lands armor break on every single target. Now Diana cuts in. She's going to be able to put up some shield.
Yeah, just going to go for that shield here to start things out for 4Baby against Juan.
Yeah, the armor breaks, of course, being coming out from Nephthys again. The skill 3.
Not able to do much, especially with all those shields stacked up as well.
The skill 3. Well, we see a Violent proc, of course. The critical link doesn't get a crit, so it didn't do much damage. Diana with the process. It is time for Pew Pew down, and I'm going to take your Ziana down with one hit.
Ziana already dismounted, now just getting burned down, already below half health as well.
Yeah, I mean, Ziana being dismounted means she is going to be bye-bye very soon. Savannah looking to secure a kill onto Lulu, but no crit. With the Violent proc, is going to be able to secure, but why do these Savannahs not crit?
Oh, missing the crit, but Lulu being out of the picture is a great news for Juan. It's been such a bane for so many of these players.
Yeah, I mean, Lulu being taken out, as you said, the bane for Juan being gone is very good news. But Savannah, she is a turn away from the Gigantic Roar, no proc, so he is going to have to wait a turn. But Diana says, no, thank you. I will not give you that extra turn. Inevitable Wound, Pew Pew, is going to seal the deal.
Juan just saw it coming and said, I don't want to have to face all of that. Well, I'll just give it to you. 4Baby going to get that win here in game one. Juan had some new ideas, but 4Baby says, nuh-uh, let's shut that right down. If you want to face me, you got to play on my game, as he leads 1-0 in this best of three in the loser's bracket for Group A.
I really like the attempt from Juan, switching it up once again. It is no longer about single target bruisers. It was about AoE this time, but just, where was the damage?
The damage just didn't come through, right? And then you had some of the shields. You had all these debuffs, but you weren't able to really capitalize on it. So the setup's there from Juan, but nothing to execute afterwards. So unfortunately for Juan, he's going to have to go back to the drawing board here in game two. He is already down 1-0. This is still only a best of three as we try to find out who will move on from this match to face Jack for a chance to go to the APAC Cup.
Indeed, as we see that the Ragdoll and the Ungilkey are not available as pre-bans this time. Ungilkey has been a pretty staple for Juan whenever it was available. Ragdoll also a staple for many players. So we are very excited to see how that shifts the draft here. Neftis and Molong taken out by both players.
Going back to some of the more common pre-bans we have seen, Neftis and Molong both either being pre-banned or picked right away in most of the games here in SWC 2021 8-pack preliminaries. Ragdoll going to be snatched up right away for Juan, keeping that away from 4Baby.
Yep, Juan definitely doesn't want to give Ragdoll away whenever he has a chance to take it away. I absolutely agree with that, as we see Lulu responds coming out of 4Baby pretty early on because it is a very consistent pick.
Lulu has just been through and through every single match, boasting still a pretty high win rate. And if you want to try to take down Lulu, you have to put in so much effort. Okeanos continues to return now in this match.
Yeah, speaking of Okeanos, we have seen a very poor win rate from this guy. So at this point, when I look at him, I'm thinking, is it a trap? Is it a mistake?
Yeah, I have to start to consider that. Ungilkey coming out alongside the Light Dragon Knight.
The flex we were talking about yesterday is already making its way through here today, as we see Kinky as the response again from 4Baby.
Kinky seems to be the go-to reliable response for 4Baby. Try to combat some of that bruiser damage coming out, and the Cocky now. So we're going to have three Onimushas in the game once again. Shushu and friends now being considered as a possible response. Juan locks it in.
To be honest, this is like a little bit of a scuffed version of flexing. It is light and dark completely, but of course, Fran and Shushu and friends, they are very accessible units, so it is showing that Juan is taking this strat very seriously. He's not looking to flex. This is a serious strategy right now.
Juan needs to get this win to stay alive in this match. Diana going to be the reliable last pick for 4Baby. Lots of options on both sides. Ragdoll and Diana going to be banned out. Looks like we might have another battle of these Onimushas on our hands.
Absolutely. All eyes on the Onimushas again with the added bonus of Jaeger this time. There are just some supports on the side. Of course, you know, supports, they're lame. We're not going to be looking at them much.
They're just there to keep the damage going for both sides right through their other bruisers.
Yeah, I mean, the Okeanos, man, this is why the win rate is suffering. The resistance out of Fran does mean that the attack buff and immunity is available. This is a huge miss for 4Baby.
That's going to hurt. We'll see if it's going to even secure the win for Juan.
I mean, we are about to see the dance coming out from Ungilkey. We know this dance hurts as he does 20-something thousand.
Once again, every time that Ungilkey just swipes across the enemy board, all of their health bars drop below half.
Yeah, I mean, literally swipe, as you said. He swipes their health away, and Cocky is looking for some response. Unfortunately, not able to take out the Ungilkey, and we see the justice.
Oh. Whoa! Oh my goodness, both monsters staying alive just a bit for now. Ungilkey is still alive!
1 HP on that Ungilkey! This is gonna swing so heavily for Juan at this point. Shushu with the heal is gonna be huge. There's a 9k followed up by an 18k. It's like the damage has never happened.
Juan is still in the beginning of the game with his HP. Meanwhile, 4Baby loses Cocky, and Okeanos still in danger alongside Kinky. That's going to be the GG out as Juan secures a comeback win in game number two, now tied 1-1 between these two players.
It feels like this Ungilkey, there's just not a lot of response for him from these players.
He gets one turn and suddenly all favor is on his side. The momentum swings so much, you can try to, you know, maybe burst him down afterwards, but even then the damage is done. So the Ungilkey proving very, very troublesome for Juan's opponents.
Yeah, I mean, props to Juan right now. He is living up to his words. He did say that in this meta, you gotta have really tanky units to survive the violent procs, and that is exactly what he did with 1 HP. Of course, the Fran resistance was there too, which allowed Juan to snowball that match as we see the bans.
Okay, Ungilkey and then the Beelzebub. So Juan doesn't want to have to deal with that in this deciding match. We saw 4Baby making good use of that monster before.
Yeah, I mean, the Ongoki ban, as you said, it was pretty predictable, but the Beelzebub, we are seeing Juan adapt to new situations as we see the Icarus being picked away from 4Baby.
So not allowing that combo to go over to 4Baby, Lulu and friends, of course, going to be secured as well for Juan. No big surprises there.
Yeah, I mean, the draft is always going to start out a little bit slow, locking in some very consistent units like Ragdoll and Diana. To be honest though, the Diana was a bit early, so Juan now has a chance to try to bring in some counters.
We'll see. Well, of course, we've seen the Antares very commonly. There's some other options as well.
Yeah.
Kinky now maybe trying to be taken away from 4Baby.
Is indeed a hard counter to Diana, as you were pointing out. So we are seeing some units here for Juan as he responds to the Diana. And of course, Kaki is going to be very consistent overall, but once again, a counter to Diana.
So the counters and just the sheer power of the Onimusha's now stacking two of them together once again for Juan. 4Baby, what is your answer here? It is down to the last game. Are we going to continue to see new monsters popping up every single game?
That seems to be the trend, as we see Viva Shell being considered by 4Baby with an Oberon. What is this strategy?
Okay, so a completely new in terms of combinations here for 4Baby out of the SWC 2021 8-pack preliminaries. Juan, he did ban the Beelzebub, but 4Baby said that's not the only thing I rely on when it comes to these decider games.
Yeah, I mean, Carnal just going to be a standard, typical response from Juan here as a way to have some response on that turn two, especially fantastic synergy with the Lulu. And of course, 4Baby, he had a triplet combo going of huge nukes, so Juan just bans out one of them.
Okay, so Oberon gets banned out, Carnal gets banned out. It is all down to this game to see who gets to continue here in the 8-pack preliminaries. They, both players, even if they win, they still have one more match against Jack to secure a spot in the 8-pack Cup on the road to SWC 2021. It's down to game three between 4Baby and Juan in round three of the loser's bracket in Group A.
Everything on the line for these players here as we see a bunch of tanky units. We've seen that 44% HP leader from Viva Shell. That does add a lot of tankiness as Kaki begins to proc away at the Diana, trying to chop off whatever HP he can.
Just gets a little bit of extra damage in the beginning, trying to keep that Diana low. Now 4Baby has a chance to answer back with Molong.
This is where it's important for the Icarus to get locked down. Unfortunately, the counter gave attack bar to Diana. At this point, utilizing skill 3 will not kill Diana, but yeah, so he just saves it.
Okay, so Diana just going to put the shields up.
And there it is, the Song of Destiny.
The Viva Shell getting so much value of that. This might be the quickest we've seen Lulu taken out in a game.
Absolutely well played by 4Baby there. He knew the attack bars were in his favor, and Ragdoll being able to finish off the job at this point means Juan, he is relying on these
Onimusha's.
Yes.
Yeah, Onimusha's. The Onimusha's. I mean, this has been his kind of go-to reliable block, but Juan, I mean, we know the Onimusha's are strong, but are they going to be enough?
I mean, that is definitely the main point we are looking at now. The armor breaks, we are seeing them come out, but is it too late as Ragdoll? What is that damage?
The damage from...
Oh, the reflect.
No, Kaki just chooses his own death as he jumps into the air, and now just down to two monsters for Juan.
I mean, at this point, we are definitely looking at Ragdoll. He has an easy kill angle onto the unit Icarus, and now at this point, it is going to be a 1v3. We are looking at Kinky with all hopes on him.
Kinky, there's been crazier things done, so can he do it? Continues to be able to get those counters as the damage isn't high enough just yet.
Yeah, I mean, right now, Molong is considering all the options. Reckless Assault is going to be his final move as we see the damage connected from Viva Shell.
Oh, Viva Shell actually getting the finishing blow to secure victory for 4Baby. Coming in, you got to give it.